Hey, welcome to Maximum Bat Speed. I want to do a video here for you parents out there or coaches out there that when you're working with a student or one of your players or your child, you're not really sure where to get started or what you should do. Now, this video right here, I'm just going to give you some basic stuff that I do when I'm working with students, what I'm looking for, what I would recommend. And again, there's so many videos out there, so many different instructors, and I know as a parent you or a coach you don't know which direction to go. I went through that many years ago trying to find out what would be best for whoever I was working with, and over the years I've learned that there's nothing more important than getting a good setup just to get your swing started in the right direction. Without that, you're going to always have to have like a domino effect of struggling, because if your setup is not correct, you're going to end up having a lot of other issues throughout the swing. So again, I'm going to give you some basic stuff that I do when I'm working with students, and keep in mind that depending on who you're working with, everyone's going to have their particular style. I do not mess with style. I leave style alone, but I do keep some of the absolutes and fundamentals that you see at the best players in the world within that parameter of what style I'm working with. So let's get started. Now, the first thing that I would do if I was working with someone, I would just right off the bat, I would tell them, let's just keep everything inside the instep of the back foot, inside the ankle. Make sure everything is just really just nice in here. Like if you were to cut this leg and cut it in half right here, you say, I want everything on the inside, okay? And the reason why is that's going to create some leverage so that your body doesn't get too far back. Now, this is not direct opposite side batter's box view. We're looking at it more kind of an angle like this. And when you do that, it does not give you a true picture of what is going on with the body. That is why when I do online video analysis, I always request direct opposite side batter's box view, okay? So again, I would just tell your child, whoever you're working with, let's just get this situated right here, okay? Now, the next thing that I would do if I was working with someone, I would tell them it's very important that when you start working with someone, that let's keep the body very balanced and very symmetrical. And by that I mean this. Now, if I draw some lines here, again, keep in mind this is not direct opposite side batter's box view. What I do is I go from the outside of the shoulders going like this, and I want to see the knees outside of the shoulders and the feet outside of the feet outside of the knees, okay? So what that does, again, that's going to give you more leverage. It's going to allow your body to be very balanced and very symmetrical. I would also ask the student and tell them, let's just get everything nice and relaxed with the arms and the hands, where everything is just nice and comfortable, okay? Now, this is very important, because if you're not balanced from the very beginning, you're going to end up, again, having to struggle with other areas of your swing as you go further. Now, as we go further here, what I would tell them is, let's just sink into that back hip socket, okay? And now, again, this is going to depend on the player. If you're more upright, you're going to probably sink more. And even if you're upright, sometimes you're not going to sink very much. But the point is that when you get into the apex of the gather, okay, when you're getting into your gather, you want to make sure that as you get, okay, and I'm going to put them here pretty much at the apex of the gather, you're going to see with the best players in the world, they're going to maintain this kind of an angle like this, okay? And again, this is not direct opposite side batter's box view, but you're going to see that the knee is going to stay inside of the ankle, and you're also going to see that there's minimal movement going on with the upper body. Now, why is this important? Because what happens is when you don't do this correctly, if you don't get into the gather correctly, you're going to end up not having a good sequence to your swing, and that is so crucial. There's a lot of things that should be going on with the bat, a lot of things going on with the body at this particular state, and I'm not going to get into it because it turned out to be a two-hour video. I'm not going to do that to you guys, but I just want you to understand, as far as the lower body is what's going on, I would recommend to do as I just said, and also with the upper body. And I'm going to have another player or two to show you exactly what's going on from them from more of a direct opposite side batter's box view, so you can get a better idea what I'm talking about. But again, just get the setup correctly, make sure you get into the gather correctly, and that's going to help you tremendously. Now, I talk about this in my videos all the time. I want to see that back elbow working up, back and behind you, as you start to get into your forward move. Now watch what's going on here with Christian Yelich, okay? This guy was just tremendous last year, and this year he's off to a very, very great start again. One of the reasons why he uses his body in a wonderful, in a very great way to create power. Now watch what's going on with his back elbow. As he starts to stride, he's pretty much going to about 60% of his height, but his back elbow starts to work up, back, and behind him as he gets into his toe touch. So right now, he's right here at now, you can see here, he's at toe touch, okay? Now what you're going to see with the best players in the world at toe touch, okay, the guys who really hit with a lot of power, they're going to have this kind of a shoulder-to-shoulder-to-elbow look where the shoulder-to-shoulder-to-elbow are all in one line with the back of the elbow. Okay, you'll see it's right in line with that. Then what you're going to see is that, I'm just going to show you something here. The eyes are pretty much going in this direction, but his shoulders are going more in this direction. Okay, why is that? Because he has great sequence and the back elbow is working up, back, and behind him, creating beautiful sequence, creating for that torque and that separation between the upper and lower body. So in other words, right now, his hips are pretty much going in this way, okay? But his shoulders, again, are going in this way, where the way that arrow's pointing right there. That's what you want, okay? So if you're working with your child, what I would do is train them to just make sure that every single time that they take a stride forward, let that back elbow work up, back, and behind them over and over till they get used to that feeling. Now from there, what I would do is as they get into heel plant, I would tell them, okay, let's get to heel plant. And when they get to heel plant, have them stop at heel plant. And what you're going to see here, just what you see with Christian Yelich, his back elbow started to slot a little bit, but as you can see here with his shoulders are still pretty much pointing to the shortstop. It would be pointing to the second baseman as a right-hander. You can see that his eyes are going in this direction, but his shoulders are still closed. Why is this important? Because that's going to help you stay with the ball longer in regards to outside pitches. It's not going to allow you to pull away. It's not going to allow you to be leaving the zone prematurely. Now from there, what I would tell them to do is let's let that lead elbow work up to the height of the mouth with the barrel below the hands. And you can see here, it is very obvious that at this stage of the swing here with Christian Yelich, and he does this beautifully, he just creates tremendous, tremendous power because his mechanics are just awesome, okay? You want to have that barrel below the hands, just like you see here with Christian Yelich, okay? You want to have this kind of a hitter's box right here. And this is all a cause and effect by having the proper pullback, by having the proper resistance, by using your body sequentially correct. Now I have a build your swing plan. It's 2 hours and 45 minutes long. And I also have bonus videos that I get into a lot of what I'm sharing in this video in great detail. And I give you drills so that this can not only become something that you apply, but you'll know exactly why it is what it is. And you're going to be able to retain it because the way I set up the video, it allows you as a coach, as a parent, as a player to retain this information, and you're going to understand why you're doing it and the purpose to every stage of the swing. Okay, so anyway, as we go further, watch what's going on here. So I'm going to just show you right here. He was at the point of contact. The next swing here, he gets to full extension. In other words, you can see here that he went from having that state where I just said where his arms are pretty much fully extended right here. See what's going on right here? And you can see here, this is just beautiful right here. And again, I'm going to back this up right here. He went from this hitter's box right here, which I just drew, to his arms being fully extended. And you can see here that the barrel is still below the hands. Now, this right here is what you see at the best players in the world with any pitch around the middle, any pitch that's slightly outside. This is what you will see in the best hitters in the world. Now, the reason why is because this allows them to stay in the zone longer. And this is what I teach, and this is what I talk about in my Build Your Swing Plan in great detail. How does this happen? How do you stay closed throughout the pitch on pitches like this? How do you get to this extension? Most players at this stage of the swing, what they're doing is they're opening up, and instead of the bat being down like this, like I'm just saying was Christian, the bat, if you have a child, you'll see that most of your children that do not have good mechanics, they're flipping slipping through the ball. Their hands are rolling over. They're not doing the palm up, palm down relative to the pitch. And by palm up, palm down, I do not mean that you have one palm horizontal like this and another palm like this. What I'm saying is palm up, palm down, okay? Palm up, palm down relative to the bat. So in other words, the bat is right here, okay? So you have one palm in this direction down in this way. You have another palm going in this direction. That's what palm up, palm down means relative to the bat. It does not mean a horizontal like you have, again, up here. You do not want this kind of palm up, palm down, okay? You want it according to the bat angle. Now, as you go further, now watch what's going on right here. You're going to see that at the best players in the world, just pay attention to what's going on here with the lower body, okay? And this is crucial. And this is something that I don't see enough at lower levels. If you're working with any player, once they get to heel plant, well, you're going to see that they're going to have an angle pretty much like this with their leg, okay? Now, this should maintain. In other words, it shouldn't deviate much more from that after you get to heel plant. Now, watch what's going on with Christian. As he starts to rotate, you can see here that he maintains where the knee stays inside of the ankle where there is a gap between the ankle going down and the knee, just like this. This is what you want. In other words, you do not want your knee out. I'm sorry, let me just erase this last one right here. And you do what you do not want is where your knee is out here, okay, and then your foot is down here. When you do that, you're going to leak your energy or your hips not to be able to rotate correctly. What you want is what Christian is doing here in this particular video. Again, as he gets into heel plant, you're going to see that this is very common and typical of the best players in the world. And the reason why is because you're going to allow the back pelvis to catch up to the front one immediately. Again, you want to have a gap down here. And again, I'm going to back this up for you so you can see what's going on right here. So as he starts to swing right here, watch what's going on right here. He gets to heel plant. Watch how immediately how his back pelvis catches up to the front one as he starts to swing because of that blocking mechanism of what's going on with the lower body. This is what I would be doing if I was working with a student or giving them an online video analysis and explaining to them how to do it. I'd give them the drills to do it. I'd send them specific videos that I have that I do not have on YouTube that gets into great detail on how the lower body works and why it works that way. Now from here, watch what's going on. As he swings, he's just going to extend. Now at this particular stage, okay, watch what's going on right here. So right here, he's getting to the point of contact. And then as he goes further, he goes post contact, and then he gets to full extension right here. Now by this time the ball is gone. Now again, what's going on with him at this stage of the swing, and this is what you pretty much see with the best players in the world, both arms are fully extended, the ball's already gone, and then from here many players will use a top hand release, okay, which means that they're going to keep the palm up, palm down relative to the bat for a long period of time. With Christian right here, you can see that he starts to roll over from here, but that's fine because he already went through the point of contact, okay? He went through the point of contact, post contact, and full extension, so he's going to be fine. A lot of players do that. I like top hand release personally, but what I'm saying is that what you're going to have with the greatest players in the world, everything that I just mentioned, for the point of contact, they're going to have their lead elbow working up to the height of the mouth. Post contact, their arms are going to get fully extended, staying closed still with the chest pointing to the opposite field, in other words, to the, in his case, pretty much to the shortstop. And then from there, they're going to let their arms fully extend. Again, too much rollover when it comes to a lot of players when they are not using their body correctly. Now I'm going to give you another example of what I was referring to. Okay, now this right here is Chris Davis. Those of you out there in the West Coast and A's fans, Chris Davis is amazing. I just love his swing. It's such a simple swing. Now again, this is not direct opposite side batter's box view, and the reason you know that is you can see here how home plate is pointing this way. Okay, if it was direct opposite side batter's box view, the home plate would be pointing like this. Okay, direct opposite side batter's box view. This is not direct opposite side batter's box view. So keep that in mind when I'm doing analysis. Okay, now what you see with Chris Davis right here, again, you're going to see, and I'm going to draw some lines, what's going on with his body. Now at this stage of the swing right here, if it's direct opposite side batter's box view, you would definitely see a gap between his knee and his ankle going down. Again, this is what you want. Just like I mentioned with Christian Yelich, okay, you want to be set up like this. It's crucial, okay? You want to have your arms relaxed. You want to have your body where it's just set up correctly. Now, what I was mentioning before, you want to have, again, if I was to draw a line, you want to have kind of a look like this. If, again, this is not direct opposite batter's box view, but you would want to have the shoulders, knees outside the shoulders and the feet slightly outside of the knees, okay? Again, that's what I would be doing if I was working with a student or doing an online video analysis. Again, this gives you leverage. It gives you great stability. Now, watch what Chris Davis does right here. As he starts to swing, just pay attention to his lower body. Watch how minimal compared to Christian Yelich as far as getting into that back hip socket. Now, he just starts to get into the back hip socket right here, and that's pretty much all he does right there. It's just a very subtle move. Watch what's going on right here. With him, this is the way he does it. And again, like I said, this is his style. But regardless of whether you do it kind of dramatically or you do it very subtly, you want to make sure that when you do this, that you maintain, again, here he is at the apex of the gather. You want to maintain this kind of an angle right here. Again, you want to maintain this kind of an angle. We're at the apex of the gather, and you go straight down like this, you're still going to have a gap right here, okay? You want to have your arms relaxed, and you want to feel very comfortable as you're getting into the apex of the gather. It is crucial that you teach your children or your players to have extremely smooth tempo. I always tell my students, you want to be in first gear all the way until you get to heel plant, and then immediately you go into fifth gear where you explode through the ball. So again, watch what's going on with his back elbow. As he starts to get into his stride, just like you see with Christian Yelich, he's going to let that back elbow work up, back, and behind him. This is what I would be doing if I was working with a student. I'd get them to master this move. And again, here he is at toe touch, and you're going to see that he's going to have that shoulder to shoulder, the elbow look where the shoulders are pretty much, again, because he's a right-hander, are going to be pointing more to the second baseman, where Christian Yelich was pointing more to the shortstop. And you can see that his eyes are pointing in this direction. So you can see there's a lot of separation between the upper and lower body. Again, this is what you see in the best players in the world. This is what you should see in pretty much all players, whether you're playing Little League, whether you're playing softball, whatever you're doing, this should be your goal, because this creates the maximum power in your swing. Now watch what's going on right here next. As he gets into his heel plant right here, again, just like Christian Yelich, what did you see with Christian Yelich? The shoulders were still closed. Again, you can see here at heel plant with the best players in the world, they produce these kind of angles where the shoulders are not opening up, and you can see his eyes again are pointing this way and the shoulders are still closed. Again, this is all a cause and effect. This is abusing your body correctly. And again, like I talk about in my Build Your Swing Plan, like I said, it's a 2-hour and 45-minute video. And I get into great detail about the sequence, about why all these things happen, what are the correct drills, what is the correct sequence, what's the correct way to use their body in order for this to occur. And because if you're not doing it correctly, you're trying to guess, believe me, you'll never figure it out. I've seen players I have worked with, even in their 30s, where they said no one has ever told them some of the stuff that I've shared with them in either a lesson or an online lesson, and they finally figured it out because no one's ever explain to them the correct sequence. And again, it is crucial that you guys have the correct sequence, the correct body movement in order to achieve these particular moves. Now watch what's going on with his elbow now, just like Christian. Lead elbow starts to work up to the height of the mouth. Watch what's going on. It starts to work up to the height of the mouth. He gets to the point of contact. Now watch right here. He gets kind of a low pitch on the outside right there. And again, this is not direct opposite batter's box view, but you can see here that right there, the elbow's pretty close to the height of the mouth. And he has this kind of a hitter's box right here. And again, the barrel below the hands. This is what you see with the best players in the world right here. And then watch what's going on next. From here, just like Christian Yelich, this is what should happen. You hit to the ball and through the ball. See how his arms are starting to get fully extended, and right there, they get fully extended, and then he just keeps them extended for a long period of time. Again, This is going to allow you to stay in the zone longer. It's going to allow you to hit the ball with your maximum power because your body is hitting to and through the ball with full extension, therefore allowing you to hit off-speed pitches better, allowing you to have a disruptive timing when your body and your bat and everything does not work in the sequence in the manner that I'm sharing with you. You're going to deprive yourself of quite a few inches, if not feet, of your bat staying in the zone so that you can have disruptive timing. This is why it's so important. So again, just like I mentioned with Christian Yelich, just like I mentioned right now with Chris Davis, they're doing the same thing. Now I'll put one more player here for you. Now this is Aaron Judge, okay? And my point I'm trying to tell you parents or coaches out there is, now I have three different players here, okay? I have Christian Yelich, I have Chris Davis, now I have Aaron Judge. Now I can put Mike Trout up here. I can put pretty much any top MLB player that hits with any power, and their style might be a little different, but you're going to see that they're all going to pretty much do exactly the same thing. And now, why is this important? Well, because these coaches out there, these players, figure out that there is a certain way that your body must work in order to be able to catch up to fastballs that are literally 100 plus miles per hour. You have to keep it minimal. You cannot be having too many moving parts. And what I teach, and when I'm working with students, and what a lot of these coaches out there teach, is that kind of mechanics, so it allows players to be able to hit Major League Baseball velocity, okay? And you have to keep it to a minimal. Your body has to be set up correctly. Now watch what's going on right here. And again, this is not also direct opposite side batter's box view, but you're going to see that it's going to be the same thing going on with him as it is with the other two players I mentioned. As you get into your setup, this is why the setup's so important. Watch how minimal his legs move as he gets into the apex of the gather. So right now he's pretty much at the apex of the gather, and if I draw a line now from the middle of his leg, okay, going down, you can see here, again, this camera is moving a little bit, but you're going to see that he has maintained that leverage of the back leg where everything stays inside of the inner thigh, inside of the inner ankle, and there's still going to be a gap down here at the bottom. This is what you want from the front side, and that's what you want from the back side. Okay, and I did an interview with a coach, and I explained a lot of this in great detail with this coach that recently interviewed me. If you want to go on my YouTube channel, you can listen to it. I get into pretty technical stuff, but I think you might enjoy it. But anyway, the point I'm saying to you coaches or parents out there working with your child, just make sure you fix the setup, okay? Make sure you do what I'm asking you to do, and the reason being is because it's going to help you tremendously so that your child or your player, whoever you're working with, is going to have minimal movement, okay? Now, as we go further here, he's at the apex of the gather, all right? And again, pay attention to what's going on right here. As he sets up right here, and just like I just mentioned to you before, remember, keep this in mind. And again, these are not direct opposite batter's box view, but if you go from the shoulders, and again, just like I mentioned, and I keep reiterating this, okay, you want to be balanced where the feet are, the knees are outside of the shoulders, and the feet are outside of the knees, okay? And again, keep that that leverage, okay, this right here, keep the inner thigh, okay, keep everything inside the inner ankle, inside the instep of your back foot, that way it's going to have more leverage, and it's going to stop you from getting this back knee to get over your back foot when you get into your swing, okay, you want to keep that to a minimal so that your body does not go too many frames into the gather. That's when a lot of players mess up, okay. So now watch his back elbow. Now he starts with his back elbow kind of high, but watch what's going to happen. As he starts to move forward, watch what's going to happen here with his back elbow. Now the back elbow starts to work up, back, and behind him as he starts to get into his toe touch. And just like Christian Yelich, just like Chris Davis, watch what happens when he gets into his toe touch. Right now he's at toe touch, and what do you see? Exactly the same thing. His shoulders are closed, okay? His shoulders are closed. His eyes are pointing in this direction over here. All that separation, just like the other two guys, pretty much landing at 60% of their height. They're landing very symmetrical, very balanced. Again, keep in mind, this is not direct opposite side batter's box view. It kind of gives you it's kind of a deception as far as how the body is right now, looking at it from the angle we're looking at it. But it is very obvious that you can see that the shoulders are closed because the back elbow is working up, back, and behind him. planting 60% of his height, and then watch what happens here. As he gets into his heel plant right here, what do you see? Same thing with the other guys again, because the body is working sequentially correctly, so that the body can have maximum torque, maximum separation between the lower and the upper body. And you can see here, even at heel plant right here, there's that separation where the shoulders are still closed. I cannot emphasize this enough. With so many players, especially when I work with them, the shoulders at this stage of the swing, instead of it being like this at heel plant, the shoulders are opened up like this, or even to the point where it's going beyond the third baseman, because there is no sequence, there's no separation, and they don't use their body correctly, and it all starts with the setup. Now watch what's going on right here. After you get to the heel plant, I would recommend for you to have your child, your player, immediately let that lead elbow work up to the height of the mouth, just like this, and with the barrel below the hand. So what do you see here? Just like you saw with both the other two players, lead elbow works up to the height of the mouth. There's the forearm, and the bat is down here. Barrel below the hands, barrel below the hands. And then you have this hitter's box. This is all a cause and effect of using your body correctly in a sequential manner, by using your body in a manner that you're supposed to. And you can see here, just like the other two players, and this is very important as well to understand, if you go from the logo going all the way down like this, what you're going to see with the best players in the world, if they get a pitch anywhere around the middle, anywhere, especially on the outside, from the logo right here, okay, the belt buckle right here, and you go all the way down to the foot right here, it's going to be one straight line. Now, why do you want this? Because what happens when you do this, it's going to give you a very, very pure rotation, so your body is working in an axis, so there's no disruption. In other words, you don't have, where a lot of players, what happens is when they swing, they're pretty much where the logo's up here, and they almost look like kind of a jackknife, kind of a look like this, okay? That is not what you want. You want to be able to do what you see Aaron Judge doing, what you see with Yelich doing, what you see with Chris Davis, what you see with the best players in the world. Watch what's going on here. He gets into his heel plant as he starts to swing. Watch how he just turns in one axis. Lead elbow works up to the height of the mouth, barrel below the hands, and again, just like the other two players, what happens? You can see here, it's very obvious that his arms are starting to extend. Watch what's going on right here. Watch that extension right here. Again, I would highly recommend for you to be, when you work with your children, whoever you're working with, just have them hit balls where they just finish with their arms fully extended like this. That's a drill that I do, and one of the drills that I have in my Build Your Swing plan, where I work with my students and I sequentially have them get to this stage eventually where they're just hitting balls like this before they even get to their full swing. This is going to ingrain a lot of good habits. And again, everything I just mentioned to you, whether it be Christian Yelich, whether it be Chris Davis, whether it be Aaron Judge, whether it be Mike Trout, it doesn't matter who I'm using. Again, the styles are going to differ, and if you're looking at these players from direct opposite side batter's box view, you're going to see, even though their body types are different, their body styles are different, and they're going to have a little bit of differences, but when it comes to the absolutes, you're going to see minimal movement in the moving into the back hip socket. You're going to see that the sequence is always going to be where everything is being maximized at the right time, pretty much all of them striding at 60% of their height, where they're going to have that shoulder to shoulder to elbow look. And you're going to see as they get into heel plant, they're going to still be closed, and then from there the lead elbow starts to work up to the height of the mouth with the barrel below the hands. They hit to the ball and through the ball with the barrel still below the hands. And again, it is crucial to understand this. Even after post contact like this, you can see that the barrel is still below the hands. Now, what you see with a lot of players, okay, many players, again, I cannot emphasize this enough, at this stage of the swing, and you can record your child next time you go to a game, I can almost assure you that most of your children will be either have their bat here, here, or even up here somewhere when they get post contact, and you're going to see that their shoulders are way opened up. Again, this video right here is to help you parents, you coaches out there, just to get some of the basics to what I do when I'm working with students. And again, my Build Your Swing plan, I truly believe will give you, again, it's with all the bonus videos and everything that I give a client when they order my videos, almost about 4 hours of information. The bonus videos I do not share on my YouTube channel. They're very, I do some of them personally, where I get into great detail explaining things that I do not explain in YouTube. And I just want you to understand that Every one of you out there, no matter who you are, I truly believe you have the ability to get your swing to a very elite level if you have the right information. And I truly believe that my video will help you to understand the swing like you've never understood it before. You're going to see things in that video that you've never even noticed before, because a lot of the stuff that I share, I don't even find it on YouTube, and I don't understand why it's not out there. But I try to share a lot of the stuff on my Maximum Bass Speed channel that many people have told me they've never seen, or even people have explained some of the stuff that I share. And I truly, I mean, there are others out there, and I have found some very, very good YouTube channel people, coaches out there that I respect very much. But believe me, there's far less than I wish I could see. So I try to give you out there a good information to help you, to help your students, help your players, help your children. All right, God bless, and give me a like if you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel and tell others about it. I really believe you're going to improve greatly by just watching my YouTube channel, and I do online video analysis as well. And I just hope that you just continue to learn this great game of baseball and softball out there. So much fun for you parents out there, I know, to watch your children succeed, and I truly believe my video is going to help you to help your child succeed. You take care. Have a great day.